celebrate the 75th anniversary of the NFL with a diamond collection of hits. As big as Nate Newton.
My claim to fame, I push other big guys out of the way so Emmitt can make a lot of yards.
As powerful as Emmitt Smith. And as strong as Reggie White. It's the 1994-95 season home video lineup.
Reggie White gets it.
Whether you love the Bengals. The Bucks.
It's caught. Touchdown.
The Bills. The Bears. The Broncos. Or the Browns, we have a team video for you. 28 exciting collectible highlights presented as only NFL films can. How do you pack 75 years of history? Action. Outrageous characters, legends, stars, and storybook finishes in one video? NFL Films has it all in their special Collector's Diamond Anniversary film.
Recovered in the end zone. The Oakland Raiders
are rolling out the right, throwing under pressure.
75 seasons, the officially sanctioned document of everything great about NFL football.
Monday Night Football.
150.
Monday Night Football.
150.
Monday Night Football, baby. The world watching.
The world champion.
For millions, it's the greatest thing to ever happen to Monday nights.
On the season premiere.
Now this special anniversary celebration captures 25 years of great games and magic moments.
Get that Monday night thing going. You ready for some football?
Relive all the memories in the best of 25 years of ABC's Monday Night Football.
Yeah, baby, Monday Night Football is where you gotta be.
Some say the personality makes the man.
Ryan's a know-it-all. Hell, head coach is supposed to win games, not friends.
I'm Steve Young, quarterback for the San Francisco 49ers, and I'm also an attorney. Personally, I think the two have a lot in common. For instance, you're allowed to make an opening statement, and then the defense can come after you. The punishment usually fits the crime.
Well, basically, I catch the ball and I run.
And I catch the ball and I
run. I catch the ball and I run.
And I
go off the field and definitely outside the lines in the NFL's greatest stars.
Shoot, I'm probably starting to sound like a broken record.
That's because I did break records.
Straight from a secret ballot, get the 100 goofiest, zaniest, funniest, klutziest plays in the history of the NFL. They're all here in the deliriously entertaining NFL 100 Greatest Follies.
Until that clock's at 0-0, no matter what, or the field goal's kicked, or we score the touchdown, it's not over. All you see is really white lines and boundaries. Once you get starting in motion and you're in a two-minute drill, things are going so fast that you don't even think about it.
Huddle up! Come on, Bobby, set a huddle, let's go!
There's nothing like a victory snatched from the jaws of defeat. Like a magician, John Elway can make the final minutes of a game last forever.
It's caught.
You can say what you want to. I don't think I want anybody back there except number 7.
Nail-biting drama, action-packed highlights in John Elway's greatest comebacks.
Let's go, we're going to get some respect today. Respect. All day long. Let's just kick their butt all day long.
The third installment in the NFL's hit collection of rock music video brings the hottest new bands, the hottest new songs in an alternative look at the NFL. NFL Rocks on the Edge. Join country music sensation Lori Morgan in a high-steppin' boot-scootin' football hoedown.
This is when the big dogs come out.
There's a good time.
tonight with a win, all right? On three. This is my night to go crazy just to see how it feels. I'm gonna dress up, gonna let my hair down like a wildcat on the prowl. Get there! This is my night to howl.
Top hits and top stars from the stage and the gridiron in NFL Honky Tonk Country. Wrap up the season with the most anticipated sporting event around the world with the Super Bowl 29 home video coming to you in February of 1995. NFL Team Videos, 75 seasons, the best of 25 years of Monday Night Football, John Elway's greatest comebacks, NFL's 100 greatest volleys, NFL's greatest stars, NFL Rocks on the Edge, NFL Honky Tonk Country, and Super Bowl 29. It's the greatest lineup in sports video history, worth its weight in gold, dazzling as diamonds in this very special 75th anniversary year. From NFL Films.
Fires the bomb up the right side for Kelvin Martin. Got it out there. Makes a great grab at the 3-yard line. Draw to Chris Ward on the left side. Cuts it back at the 5. Touchdown, Chris Ward.
It's the team, though. I don't know.
Throw Seahawks a couple of the blitz, fires it out there. Intercepted the end zone by Eugene Robinson. First and 10, Cleveland 23. Meyer play fake to Warren. Looking, scrambling to his right. Meyer looking for help. Fires up the right sideline. It is caught. Touchdown by John L. Williams.
At the end of the 1992 season, the Seattle Seahawks flashed a signal to the rest of the league. In the uncharted new world of free agency, team management was going to take an aggressive approach in acquiring talent. Tom Flores and his coaching and scouting staff set their sights on the veteran players they wanted, then moved quickly to bring them to the Kingdome. The signing of Colt center Ray Donaldson added instant stability to the offensive line. And when ex-Dolphin tight end Farrell Edmonds came aboard, he brought along run-blocking skills and pass-catching flair. Joining Edmonds in the receiving corps was a former member of the world champion Cowboys wideout Kelvin Martin. Kmart's Blue Light Specials included the ability to make something out of nothing and the speed and moves to burn opponents deep. Martin's yards per catch average ranked among the AFC's best, and few receivers anywhere possessed a better understanding of their craft.
You know what I'm saying? He broke before I broke out. I was like, my goodness. That's why I tried to shield him with my body. I came right back. I said, hey, let's go 9. Let's go 9, man.
Meyer, short drop, pump fake. Now fires the ball up the left side, throwing to Martin out there. He's got the football at the 15. Touchdown, Seahawks.
The contributions of Donaldson, Edmonds, and Martin were proof that Seattle's free agent choices had been wise ones. The same held true with the college draft, where the Seahawks were sitting pretty, harvesting one of the most appealing rookie crops in the NFL. The defensive picks included number 95, linebacker Dean Wells, and end Michael McCrary, number 75, who was fast enough to cover the pass and sack the quarterback. Another pocket buster was number 67, Antonio Edwards, who took special pleasure in tormenting the Broncos' John Elway. And no defender made a splashier NFL entrance than cornerback Carlton Gray.
Stepping up, rolling to his right now, firing the bomb up the right side, got a man out there, and it is intercepted by Carlton Gray. His third interception on the season. This rookie, a sure first-round draft choice that falls to the second round, and the Seahawks were happy about that. They just love this kid.
The rookie who made the biggest hit was special teams terror Michael Bates.
Into the end zone. Mel Gray will take it 2 yards deep and bring it out. The Seahawks knock him down. He fumbles the football. Michael Bates made the tackle, and I believe he...
A former Olympic medal winner in the 200-meter run, Bates is blessed with sprinter speed and a killer instinct. When Michael isn't returning kicks, he's covering them, making his targets feel as if they'd just checked in to the Bates Motel. No Seahawk ever made more special teams tackles in a season, and nobody could put the opposition in the hole like Michael Bates.
This one is a low spiral bounce. It's inside the 10, inside the 5. Michael Bates touches it, knocks it out of bounds at the 1 yard line. How he does not get voted into the Pro Bowl, I have no idea.
But the one pick that turned around the fortunes of the franchise came early in the 93 draft, when Seattle made the selection that instantly revitalized its offense.
With the second choice in the draft, the Seattle Seahawks select Rick Meyer, quarterback, Notre Dame.
You know, this is a team that's rebounding. Hopefully I get a chance to play, and when I do, hopefully I get a chance to do well, but I'm not going to put any pressure on myself that doesn't need to be on there right now. It's a tough battle. It's a lot different than college ball. That wasn't easy, but this is just a whole nother level above it. But I prepared myself physically to be strong enough to take a hit and be able to get back up.
Meyer proved to be a quick study, tripling the Seahawks' wins and doubling their point total from the year before. He became the first rookie passer in 20 years to start every game, adding each week to his legion of true believers.
Meyer is one of those guys who shows a lot of poise, a lot of field presence. He knows when to run and has a tremendous arm. He's just going to be a tremendous quarterback for the future.
Definitely he's a fast guy, and he don't make the mistakes that a young guy would make at a quarterback position. So that's going to mean that he's going to be something to see in upcoming years.
In 1993, Meyer set new NFL records for attempts, completions, and yardage by a rookie quarterback. And he accomplished this even though his on-the-job training took place against some of the league's toughest teams.
A lot of people have told me just to be yourself and to be patient and let things come. Coach Cannon was the first one to tell me that. You can't try to do it all one day and be a hero. It's just going to come in time.
Rick's time arrived by midseason, first against the Chargers. He passed for one score and ran for another to post Seattle's highest offensive output in nearly 4 years. A few weeks later, Meyer was tough in the clutch against the Patriots.
Third down and long. Here comes the blitz. Meyer scrambling to his left, trying to buy some time. Does. Looks. Fires back against the grain. Got a man out there. Kelvin Martin caught the football. He's got it at the 47-yard line. How in the world did he find Kelvin Martin back there?
Trailing 9-3 in the final moments, the eventual AFC Rookie of the Year marched his team downfield with the calculated poise of a 10-year veteran.
Third down and goal from the 1 yard line with 28 seconds to play. Meyer short drop, flares it out. Touchdown! Five! The more they say Rick Meyer looks like Joe Montana, the more I'm beginning to believe it.
Hopefully there'll be a lot of crunching out there today.
And we won't be on the receiving end. We'll be delivering those crunches.
Once again, in 1993, defensive captain Eugene Robinson was the bearer of bad tidings to opposing ball carriers, logging more tackles than any other Seahawk, while totaling the most interceptions of anyone in the NFL. Robinson's 9 thefts and 2 fumble recoveries gave him the best turnover total in football. So it came as absolutely no surprise to anyone when Eugene was voted to the Pro Bowl for the 2nd straight season.
So Donald in the shotgun, stepping up the throw, hitting pressure, Seahawks after him, and they score back at the 26-yard line.
Steve, I'm going to tell you, that was as great an individual defensive effort by Eugene Robinson as I have ever seen.
Robinson faced a secondary that enjoyed relatively good health in 93, even if the opponents they covered did not. Corners Dwayne Harper and Patrick Hunter, and safeties Robert Blackman and Raphael Robinson, starred as acrobatic defenders against the deep strike. But while the secondary remained intact, the rest of the defense had to compensate for key injuries.
Here it is, 42 trick covers lock, ready? Cover lock.
The first to step forward was Rod Stevens, number 94. Seattle's middle linebacker covered the field from sideline to sideline, called the formations, and tied an NFL record with a pair of safeties. And Rod would have broken that record if it hadn't been for his heads-up play against the Cincinnati Bengals.
A give to Green around the left side. Seahawks have got it. Could be a safety. Ball on the end zone. Seahawks have recovered for a touchdown.
Holy mackerel.
Rod Stevens is the guy who recovered the fumble for a Seahawks score. How about that one, baby?
Stevens was flanked by Terry Wooden, number 90, who started every game while finishing second on the team in tackles. On the other side, number 98 Kevin Murphy stepped in to plug the gap after a torn Achilles tendon prematurely ended the season for pass rushing specialist Rufus Porter. Another player lost to injury was defensive end Michael Sinclair, number 70, who averaged nearly a sack per game and finished third among AFC pass rushers in that department. With both Sinclair and Porter out of action for half the season, Seattle's defensive assistants worked overtime to compensate for their absence. The coaching staff mixed and matched the lineup with veterans and rookies in hopes of striking just the right combination. Number 99, Natu Tua Tagovailoa, started nearly every game at right end, bringing quickness and lateral movement to the position. Inside, second-year tackle Tyrone Rogers, number 91, displayed up-the-middle pass-rushing capabilities. And as always, the diehards, 12-year veterans Jeff Bryant and Joe Nash, continued to make big plays.
Looking, still looking. Now it breaks down. He lobs it, batted in the air, and it is intercepted by the Seahawks. At the 10, at the 5, touchdown, Joe Nash!
But once again, the Seattle defender that drew everyone's attention was Cortez Kennedy.
And you got there before I did.
Cortez Kennedy is a load.
His size and talent is so mammoth, so monstrous, that it only seemed logical to cast Kennedy as Tez Rex, the frightening ghoul featured in a national television commercial. But that fictitious character is only too genuine to opposing ball carriers. They see him in their dreams, wake up in a cold sweat, and then realize their worst nightmare is stalking them for real every Sunday. It hardly seems fair that a man that large can be so fast. But it's part of the reason why Kennedy was voted to the Pro Bowl for a third straight season. Perhaps an even greater sign of respect came each week when the other team routinely assigned two or even three blockers to contain him.
Everywhere I go, they got somebody.
The extra attention often freed up a teammate to make a big play.
Got from behind, fumbles the football, Seahawks, pick it up, Eugene Robinson, touchdown, Seahawks!
Through it all, Kennedy never lost his sense of humor.
I don't know if it was a pass or what, but I know I got flipped. I couldn't even see what's going on.
Yeah.
I won't do that again. Don't bring that over here. I said it. You heard me.
While the Tez gave opponents an earful, the Seahawk defense provided an eyeful of thrills during their best effort of the season, a win over the Browns.
Back to throw as Philcox setting up. Philcox side the ball, battled away. It's fumbled. The Seahawks are after it. Touchdown, Seahawks.
That's the way to start.
It was the fastest score in Seattle history and was merely the first of a record-tying seven turnovers.
Metcalf around the right side, cuts back to the 45, fumbles the football, and the Seahawks will recover at their own 46-yard line.
Philcox drops back to his own end zone. Got him. Pressure. Edwards has got him. Antonio Edwards for a safety.
You ever see anything like this before? Unbelievable performance by the defense.
If you don't make the big play, who's going to do it?
Let's go!
Yeah. One, yeah. Two, three, half!
Even in early summer, the Seahawks special teams were already primed for action.
Montgomery gets the kickoff, and it comes down McLuhan at his own 25-yard line. To his left, gets one block to the 30, 35, open field, 45, 50. McLuhan's going to go the distance. Touchdown, Seahawks, Dave McLuhan.
Seattle's kicking tandem also contributed. Rick Tootin broke his own club record for punting average, and place kicker John Casey scored 98 points while booting the longest field goal in team history. Overall, Seattle's attack was far more productive than the season before. The offensive assistants went to work, putting their creative ideas in the hands of a unit whose talent level had vastly improved. Of course, one way to increase scoring was to have a healthy Brian Blades available for an entire season. Playing in every game, Blades returned to his old form as one of the NFL's best possession receivers. Brian snared so many drive-extending catches that he was able to break Steve Largent's franchise record for most receptions in a season.
Dan dropping straight back, looking with good protection, down the middle, fires, and it's caught for a touchdown! Brian Blades! What a catch he made!
Elsewhere on offense, the line blocking may not have been as appealingly choreographed as the Seagals' dance routines, but in their own way, the Hawks' pit crew was a unit of precision and purpose. Joining center Ray Donaldson were veteran guards Derek Brills, Bill Hitchcock, and draft day steal Jeff Blackshear. Starting every game at the tackles were Andy Heck and Ray Roberts, who made considerable strides in his sophomore season. Ray's responsibilities ranged from protecting Rick Myers' blindside to even occasionally hauling in one of the rookies' redirected pass attempts. Fortunately, the glue-fingered Roberts got plenty of assistance from the rest of Seattle's receiving corps. Doug and Rob Thomas were integral members of the third-down offense. And when the Seahawks needed more blocking beef or a big pass target, they turned to tight end Paul Green. Additional blocking and receiving help came from fullback Tracy Johnson, number 43, who capably backed up John L. Williams. Williams concluded his eighth season in Seattle with a flourish, finishing second on the team in pass receptions, while posting his best yards per rush average since 1988. Seattle's offensive captain completed an especially rare trifecta on the season's final day. With 102 yards against the Chiefs, John L. became the third different Seahawk in consecutive weeks to rush for 100 or more yards in a game.
Second down, giving on the draw to John L. to 25, 20 to the 15, 10. John L. to the 5, breaks the tackle, touchdown Seahawks! John L. Williams!
For the first time ever, the Seahawks led the AFC in rushing, and the point man of the ground attack was Chris Warren. In his second season as a starter, Warren earned a trip to the Pro Bowl by displaying running and receiving talents that few big backs in the NFL could ever hope to duplicate. In a win at New England, he set a new team record for carries in a game, along with a personal best 174 rushing yards and the game-clinching score.
Gilbach gives to Warren. At the 15, 10, at the 5, Chris Warren, touchdown, Seahawks!
Despite an abdominal injury that kept him out of the season's final two games, Chris still finished third among all conference rushers by gaining 1,000 yards for the second straight year.
Around the left side, gets a block, 45, 40, leaps over a man, 35, inside the 30, Warren is gone, touchdown Seahawks! Chris Warren looking tough today.
In the final home game of the season, the Seahawks hosted the Steelers, who desperately needed a victory to keep their playoff hopes alive. But the Seattle defense wasn't going to let that happen.
Back to throw as O'Donnell, Seahawks come with four. Good protection, fires left, complete the green, 45. The big guy in midfield fumbles the football. Seahawks recovered, Eugene Robinson. Eugene across midfield to the Pittsburgh 49.
The Steelers were held to only a pair of field goals, while the Seahawk offense controlled the game virtually from start to finish. Quarterback Rick Meyer displayed his versatility by breaking free for his longest run of the year, then entrusted ball-carrying duties to reserve tailback John Vaughn. In his first start as a Seahawk, Vaughn gained 131 yards, dashing over, around, and through the NFL's top-ranked defense against the run.
Gives it Vaughn over the left side, breaks it to his left, 20, 25, 30, 35-yard line, Vaughn, 45, 50, and out of bounds at the Pittsburgh Steelers 43-yard line.
And when it was time to pass, Rick Meyer knew just what to do.
Second down and goal, Meyer play fake. Scrambling to his left, looks, touchdown, and Paul Green!
The 93 season is over, and the Seahawks are now pointing to 1994. Seattle's front office has stayed active in the marketplace by signing league co-interception leader Nate Odoms and all-pro tackle Howard Ballard, both from the AFC champion Buffalo Bills. And those moves are only the beginning. With more opportunities available through trades and the draft, the Seahawks will work to stockpile the best talent available as they continue their quest to become one of the NFL's elite franchises. In 1993, Seattle made bold strides and staged a remarkable turnaround. In 1994, the Seahawks' goals will be even greater, setting the course for a winning season and getting back on track for a return to the playoffs.